mzaa akikufa kama Ogolla, mtoto wake hafai kumshika baba yake akiwa uchi. Nilipoona kijana ameenda kwa kaburi ku receive baba yake, na mnajua hakuwa kwa geneza, kwa jeneza alikuwa uchi. Hiyo lazima watu watafute wazee wafanye tambiko. Hiyo maneno haikwenda mzuri. Alafu kijana anaambia watu ati msiongee, ati msiongee. Sisi tunasema ina funeral, tunalia vile tunataka. General Ogolla hakukua tu property ya familia hiyo, nucleus family. Alikuwa property ya Jamhuri ya Kenya. Sasa kwa kijana kusema ati general, ati tusikatae, ati sijui walikuwa marafiki wapi, ati alikuwa anaenda state house sijui wapi, I think hata kama amefiwa, he is absolutely wrong and unacceptable. Kenyans wanted truth about the death of General Ogolla, and we want nothing but the truth. Wewe kijana, tunakuombea Mungu akupatie nguvu uendelee kumwona baba yako, lakini wacha sisi tumwone General Ogolla kama wa Kenya. Wachana kutuletea, you can't gag us. Wacha kutuambia Ogolla alikuwa general wa majeshi ya Kenya, hakuwa general wa familia. Sasa to that extent, wewe lia pole, ugua pole pole kwa nyumba, achia wazee wa jamii ya Wajaluo wa take over rituals na wafanye tambiko. Msipofanya tambiko, hii mtoto ameharibika. Fanya tambiko. Kijana yetu, ndugu ya Ogolla, sisi kama wana western tuko na mila na tamaduni na desturi. Kitu ya kwanza, Ogolla, General Ogolla alipokufa, bibi ya Ogolla ni property ya jamii ya Ogolla, ikiongozwa na his uncles, ndugu zake. So it is wrong kusema, kijana kusema ati mimi naenda kutekea ya mama yangu. Why not take ya mama yako? Unajua needs zake. This was very 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 unfortunate, very unfortunate. Two,
na watu wache kusema hizo maneno zao ati he did this. These guys were friends in state house. Nyinyi amjai kuenda huko. Mimi mzendo alikuwa ananiambia anapenda president sana, though are good friends. So hiyo maneno from today, unless you're quoting me, muachane nayo. Na kwanza hiyo bloggers who is posting those things, let me just say, your excellency, when my mom called me and told me your dad has gone down in a helicopter crash, they're very useless bloggers. You're so quick to post pictures. I've been told by my mother my father's gone down. 10 minutes later I'm seeing a helicopter burning. What does that mean? Of course he's dead. And people are so insensitive. So you broke the news. Umepewa EGH for breaking the news that the general is dead. Let us be sensitive, tafadhali. Bloggers, watu ya media, mwambie wa bloggers wache mchezo. I'd mention them by name, lakini yo tabia pana. And I really want to appreciate, I won't mention the person who finally told me mzee has rested and really encouraged me in that moment and told me now is the time to be strong. Kwa hayo mengi na machache, mabibi na mabwana, asante ni sana. I want to clear the air with the conversations I had with my father about his time with the president. He didn't really divulge any national security issues, but generally I feel it's important to first of all clear the air. The president didn't have to appoint him first of all, and initially he saw his competencies and decided that this is the man for the job. But very quickly they started becoming friends and they formed a serious chemistry, which he would tell me, I have had a very good meeting with the boss. Not telling me what it is. And it's not the president alone, the deputy president as well. Really enjoyed his company. They formed a serious working security relationship of securing the country. And his cabinet secretary. These people became like brothers. I've seen someone on Twitter saying, it was this rules, the president was in a corner. And I actually feel bad for the three of them, because I know it went beyond the working relationship and they were working to change this country very seriously. And it's a serious blow to the three of them. That one I'm saying, I talked to him personally. None of you know that information, but I know he had a very, very good working relationship with His Excellency. na hata niliona excellency jana umeshika macho kidogo, watu wakasema hii ni machozi ya crocodile, these are fake. In my heart, from what I know it was genuine. I know it was genuine.
My father always alikuwa na mambo matatu kama wewe, not the same, but all his speeches were divided into three. Today I'll divide it into four because he was a foster general. Firstly, you heard from Bishop Lele about his love for God. Somewhere in that helicopter wreck is his Bible, which was his most precious possession. Anyone who worked with him in DHQ, MAB, LAB, wherever, can attest that he always had a Bible with him. And I am hoping they're able to retrieve it from the accident. I'd want to keep it as a memento, and for the rest of the family as well. His Bible meant a lot to him, and between me and him, the rest of the family, my mom and my wife, were a bit slow, but we'd always engage in a competition for reading the Bible and discuss the mortality and all these things of life. He understood that his position was temporary and it would always end. Leading up to his death, he almost knew that his time was up. Despite having very many plans for the military and for his family, but he spoke in a certain tone that would suggest that, my son, I won't always be here, and you will need to take care of my wife and my other children, which I am more than ready to do, and it will not be a problem.